parallel lines, transversals, and angles, a la Shmoop. There are some couples who are just destined to be together forever. Romeo and Juliet, Cinderella and Prince Charming, Paula Deen and Butter. But the greatest couple of them all has to be parallel lines. Parallel lines never touch, but they always stand by their partner. Now that's love. When a transversal cuts across two parallel lines, it forms eight angles. If the measure of angle one is 110 degrees, what are the measures of the other seven angles? First, we can see that angles one and three are vertical angles, and we know that vertical angles are always congruent. In other words, they have equal measurements. So angle three has a measure of 110 degrees too. It also helps to know that corresponding angles, or angles that are in the same position relative to the parallel lines and the transversal, are also congruent. In this case, the corresponding angle to angle one is angle five. So angle five is also 110 degrees. Wait, so angles three and five are congruent too? Actually, yes. They're both on the interior between the two parallel lines and on alternate sides of the transversal. So we call them alternate interior angles. All alternate interior angles are congruent. And there's one more angle that's 110 degrees, and that's angle 7. So angle 1 and angle 7 are both on the exterior of the parallel lines and alternate sides of the transversal, and they're called alternate exterior angles. Alternate exterior angles are also congruent, and we can check that using vertical angles or corresponding angles. Yep, looks like 110 degrees to us. Those are all the odd angles, but what about the evens? We know that a straight angle, or a line, has 180 degrees. Since any even angle makes a linear pair with an odd angle, any even angle is supplementary to an odd angle. That means the even angles have a measure of 180 minus 110, or 70 degrees. And ta-da, you now have all your angles. So don't forget to include parallel lines when listing the world's great love stories. And as a bonus tip, don't ever try to get between Paula Deen and her butter. Woo!
What did the buffalo say to his son as he left for school?
Bye, son. Okay, bad joke, but if you survived it, how about clicking the subscribe button below? And if you're looking for more jokes from yours truly, why not check out our website at www.shmoop.com? And if you want to get updates on what's new, well, check us out on Facebook and Twitter, too. Please check our Facebook and Twitter pages, please.